welcome back to my channel. And today I'm going to do a get ready with me for a corporate office slash work slash appropriate makeup. So this is what I came up with. It's very simple. It's very natural, I think, at least. And it's all about perfecting the base of your makeup and evening your skin tone and then really just applying the minimal natural looking makeup that you can. So if you want to see how I did this look, then please continue watching. So I've already moisturized my skin with my Hada Labo Hydraluron lotion, and then on top of that is my what is it called, it's the Ole Henriksen Truth hydration cream or something like that. So anyway, I'm starting off with a primer, which I don't normally do, but I just want to use up the primer, to be honest. This is the Corus anti-aging primer, and this is silicone free, and that's what that looks like. I like this because it's not one of those primers that, like, how do I explain it, that just slides off your face like the silicone based ones do. This is more of a lotiony type. So I'm just putting that in the areas that I would normally get really oily, which is like my cheek, my T-zone. So there you go. I'm gonna bring down the camera a little bit. Okay, there you go. So that's a better angle. Yeah, that's what's happening. I'm gonna go ahead and mix my two foundations, which is the Becca Ultimate Coverage Complexion Cream in Bamboo and Noisette. All right, there you go. I'm just gonna take like half a pump of each, so then you get equal one pump. And I'm also going to add in a little bit of the Josie Maran Argan Illuminizer so that it kind of looks dewy, because this foundation is very matte. I wouldn't say that it looks like what do you call that, it doesn't look like it's really flat. I would actually say it's demi matte, but I just want to add a little bit more luminosity on my skin. So I'm going to go ahead and mix that on my mixing palette, and I'm going to apply it with my Sigma what is this, F84. I've spritzed water on my foundation brush, and I am going to concentrate it in the areas that I needed, which is like my chin area or my mouth area, to give it the coverage that it needs, because God knows I need coverage there. I don't know why. Well, I do know why. It's the time of the month, so I've got all my hormonal acne popping out on my chin. Even got like a sore mouth sore over there on my lip. So I'm just gonna pat this with this brush. I start with just a little bit and then build it up if I need to, just because I don't want to waste the product. It's not a cheap foundation to begin with. But you can see how well it covers, like all of the red bumps and the hyperpigmentation that I've got on my chin from all of my acne scarring is gone. Dark circles, because I didn't get much sleep last night. We were up watching The Theory of Everything on TV. I got a copy of it, and then when we turned off the computer, the internship was on TV, so we ended up watching that as well. And by we, I mean me and Duncan, obviously. I'm going to drag this down just so it evens out, because my neck is lighter than my face. Okay, gonna set that foundation. The eye area will be set by my Hourglass Ambient Lighting Powder in Dim Light. That's what that looks like. I'm gonna go ahead and take a kabuki brush and just like do that. So there you go. And also like the center of my face. So that's about that much highlight that I'm gonna do with that. And then the rest of my face will be set by my MAC Mineralized Skin Finish Natural in Medium Deep, which is also a tad bit darker than my skin. So this is actually going to serve as a little bit of a contour. See how that kind of warmed up and bronzed my skin right there. Gonna put that on temples. And that's it. So you got like the center of your face highlighted and the sides sort of darker. So that's the contour that I'm going to have today. That's it. Okay, let's proceed with the brows. Okay, so I've done one brow, and really what I only do is fill in my brows and follow the shape of it, extending it a little bit because they end a little short. So I'm just really filling this in with what's on the product. I dip it once in my Tarte brow mousse, and that's it. No product added, that's it. And I just fill it in. See, like so. I'm going to take the spoolie and run that through so that it's not too much. Eyebrows on fleek. I don't even know what that means, but yeah, whatever. I'm just going to make sure that they're as same size as each other. Yeah, pretty much the same. That should do. I'm going to go in with my MAC Rubenesque Prolonger Paint Pot. I'm just going to put that. Oh, this is starting to dry out. Brilliant. I'm going to put that all over the lid. And as you can see, it's going to disappear from my eyes on my lids, because it kind of just looks like the same color as my skin, except that it's got a little bit of sheen on it. I could actually end it here, like, I mean this, the eye part, but I just want to do a little bit on the crease. Doesn't matter if you get that prolonged wear all the way in, because it really doesn't really have that much color anyway to begin with. So that's that. I'm going to take my Lorac Pro palette and a sort of crease brush and go in there with, shall we say, Sable, right there. This color over here. Okay, I'm just gonna put that at the tip of my brush, and then looking down my crease, just gently put that in. There you go. That's about it. Of course, I'm going to repeat it on the other side. So you got a little bit of definition over there already. Now I'm going to go in with a highlighter. I'm not sure which one I'm going to use. Which one do you think should I use? Let me see. I'm going to go in with my Marc Jacobs highlighter in Overt, which is sort of an olive green. And I'm just going to line my lash line. I'm not going to do anything like winged liner or whatever. I'm just going to go ahead and deepen the lash line with this olive color. If you've seen my review on this eyeliners, I'm not a big fan of it. I find that they don't stay long enough on my lash line. In fact, after 2 hours, they pretty much disappear. So really, I'm not a fan. As you can probably tell. I like the gel consistency. They go on very smoothly, but yeah, staying power on my oily lids isn't very good. I'm smudging that out. Bringing it out a bit. There you go. So you can see the difference with the two eyes. This one is, I don't know, a little bit more defined. So of course I'm going to repeat the process on the other eye. Now I've also put on mascara. I used my Shiseido eyelash curler and my Chorus in mascara in Obsidian Black. So that's what's on my lashes and my lower lashes as well. And now I'm gonna go in with a Laura Mercier loose blush powder in filtered brown. They call it a face tint. I don't know why. There's way too much coming out. This is why I don't like powdered products, just because, or loose powder product to be more specific. It's because they make such a mess. But they're gorgeous. What can I say? Just putting that on the apples of my cheeks with a Tarte blush brush. And this is like a dusty rose color, so it looks quite natural. There you go. I'm gonna go back in with that kabuki brush that I used to dust my face, just to blend that out. There you go. And then for the final part is the lips, and I have here my Too Faced Perfect Lips lip liner in Perfect Spice. That's what that looks like. There you go. And I'm going to line my cupid's bow. It's gonna go ahead and follow my lip line. I don't really like to overdraw. And then I slowly fill it in with that. It's a beautiful nude color. And then I'm gonna top that with the Tarte Lip Surgeons in Grateful. Which gives a bit of sheen. And that is now my office appropriate makeup. Well, corporate office. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope you like this video. Thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. Bye.